It's Madden NFL 22, and tonight's clash of conferences is just moments away. It's the Patriots and the Falcons coming up next.
A full house expected here tonight, over 70,000, and the fans still filing in to Mercedes-Benz Stadium just west of downtown Atlanta. A moment ago, here was the scene, the Falcons coming out from their tunnel to the roar of all the folks here in Atlanta. We're ready for football as these Falcons get set to match up with the New England Patriots. Brandon Gordon alongside, as always, my partner Charles Davis and CD. In the few moments here before kickoff, let's give these folks at home a look at these two offenses by the numbers. What stands out to you?
Brandon, I just continue to be amazed by the analytics of the game, and it's an area where I continue to concentrate and study because I'm still trying to figure out how coaches and coordinators can really crunch the numbers and find where exactly on the field a defense is vulnerable. It's the game within the game. And if you really dive into it, it can be endlessly fascinating.
Here's the punter, Jake Bailey, ready to do the honors. And we are underway from Atlanta. On the return, here's the dangerous Cordarrelle Patterson. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line.
Let's go!
And the Falcon offense about ready to go to work here for the first time. And leading them, as he has since 2008, is the veteran quarterback, former MVP, Matt Ryan.
And I think if there's one quarterback in the league who sometimes gets taken for granted, to me, it's Matt Ryan, because I think throughout his career, he's been consistently excellent. Frequent member of the 4,000-yard club, savvy veteran, knows how to throw the deep ball and create big plays. And yes, he will beat you from the pocket.
This is Cordarrelle Patterson. Remember, he won a ring with the Pats. Now the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. But you often say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. A shotgun handoff to Patterson, and he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
Second and 2 is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down, keep the sticks moving.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Now Ryan. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
So much for the best laid plans and best designed plays. That was good coverage along the sidelines. No place for that one to get in there. It sails incomplete.
Second and 10. Patterson on the carry. And he'll get this up past the 45 to the 47. That'll leave him with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
And that's the kind of run that gets everyone excited on offense. And you know, oftentimes the guys who carry the ball are the ones in the huddle doing the chirping. Right now, I think it's the offensive line telling them, run it again. We are right there about to break a big one.
Ryan now off the bootleg. And this is going to be incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
On fourth down, on is Dustin Colquitt to kick this away. Back deep for the Patriots, Gunnar Olszewski. Yikes, terrible kick headed straight for the sidelines.
We got this.
The Patriot offense ready for their first drive, led by Mac Jones, the Heisman Trophy finalist and 15th overall selection this spring from Alabama.
And he's the latest in a line of Alabama quarterbacks that are potential NFL starters. Sat behind Tua Tagovailoa patiently, waiting his turn, and in 1 year as a starter, exploded on the scene. 41 touchdown passes to just 4 interceptions, 77% completion percentage. He had it going. Alabama won a national title, and now here he is getting his shot in the NFL.
Throwing Jones. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. And this one is incomplete.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
Here's second and 10. Now Jones. Incomplete.
Looked like they had an opportunity for a big play across the middle, but he didn't have the concentration or the focus necessary and dropped it before he could haul it in.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. Looking to throw. Jones. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. 15 yards there for number 15.
And another thing that makes a comeback route really effective is that oftentimes after you've made the initial move, receivers breaking away from the defensive back, and that makes it a really tough play to defend. And nice chunk of yardage picked up there.
They'll run with a former member of the Crimson Tide, Damian Harris. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Moving backwards on first down, never a good thing. What does that do for the mindset on second down?
Well, it changes your play call, definitely, because as a play call, you're advancing yourself, thinking, okay, we're going to get a gain here. Now you've got to go back in reverse, come up with something to pick up not just the yardage lost, but gain a few extra.
On second and 11 now. Jones. And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Marlon Davidson. What a play by him. That's going to go as a loss of 13.
Boy, Charles, that time he took a bad situation and made it worse.
Yeah, you're almost putting together a nice little song there, aren't you? Because it's something you'll see from young quarterbacks. They have that tendency to retreat backwards instead of stepping up in the pocket.
Work now for Jones and the Patriots here after the sack. It's third and long. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
And the AFC's Pro Bowl punter last year, Jake Bailey, on a punt for New England. Avery Williams deep for Atlanta. There'll be 37 yards there on the punt, and the Falcons will be taking over first and 10. So for the second time in this one, we get set to see the Falcons offense.
and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
Ryan will bring the Falcons up now, first and 10 at their own 23. Now Ryan. He completes this to Russell Gage. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one. On second down, it's Patterson. It'll be a gain of two on the play, but they'll remain a few inches short here with third down looming.
We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Boy, no chance as he was met and dropped behind the line there. Not at all what they envisioned on third down, 3 yards in the wrong direction.
Well, let's face it, that's just a helpless feeling for a running back there. He's looking up to find a hole, and all he finds is a whole lot of ticked off linebacker.
Here's Dustin Colquitt now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. Olszewski now to return. Found good room to run there. Returns it 14 yards. And the Patriots take over. So back onto the field come the Pats for their second drive. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at the 45. They turn to Harris to begin the drive. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. He was brought down by Foyasade Aluakin.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. On the give, this is Harris. Pushes past him. And now running right through him. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
That was a good forceful run, and it demonstrates why you've got to put your body on a runner when you're trying to tackle him. If you just go in there and just try and get him down with arm tackles, usually doesn't work very well. And we saw in that play, he'll run right through those attempted plays.
And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line.
Well, partner, none of these runs individually have added up to a whole lot.
Now, three plays, all three short runs, but together a first down.
Yeah, it's amazing how the narrative changes when you string them together.
Now a first down carry for Harris. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
From the 41, Jones. Open man is Kendrick Bourne.
And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons 26. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. And he went in route there from the slot for the completion.
Love how he runs his routes because it's all setting up your defender. Give him a little something one way, take it the other way. Head and shoulder fake. Sometimes you make one step to the outside, then break it inside. Really well run route.
They'll run on first down. It's Harris. Grady Jarrett with the tackle.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're a back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. From the gun, Jones. Open man is born. And they just keep marching right along. First down on a pickup of 8 there. No score after 1 on EA Sports. Start of the 2nd quarter, and it's the Patriots in control of the football as they've got it with a 1st and 10. Here, losing yardage to the 14. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up 2nd and 11.
Defensively, he has been a presence in their backfield in the first half. Had a sack earlier, and now he comes up with a big tackle for a loss.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's 2nd and 11. Back to throw. Jones. He's going to be sacked back at the 23-yard line. But that's Grady Jarrett who forced his way through to register the sack.
Enough takes to start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a 3rd and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
Work now for Jones and the Patriots here after the sack. It's 3rd and long. Jones throwing on 3rd and long. Throw left side complete. Brad Smith. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to 4th down.
He wasn't the primary target, but I think it was almost like a check down situation, wasn't it?
Yeah, hoping he can break some tackles, a big tight end, but he couldn't do it.
Yeah, get it to that big frame and hope he can scatter some bodies, unable to get it done.
And Folks' kick is good. And the Patriots jump out to a 3-0 lead. So a good kick there, and they put the bow tie on it with 3 points.
And let's face it, everybody wants a touchdown. We know that. But in the NFL, defenses are awfully good. You're not going to score each and every time. Be able to knock the ball through the post and take the 3.
By the way, I said bow tie. I meant just bow. Not the tie, but yeah.
Either way.
You got it.
I just went right past it.
Now, after the field goal, Bailey will kick it away. Now it's Patterson. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return.
Shut him down! Shut him down! Let's do this!
Here comes the Falcon offense now as they get set to take over here. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. They're going to start the drive here on the ground with Patterson. And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run. But the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
From the 35 on second down, Ryan.
He decided to run a hitch route. It really helps to have a guy who can turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
Oh, it's a nickel set here defensively on third and inches.
Still want to be prepared for a pass.
Out of the gun, it's Ryan. Got a man right side, it's Sharp. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. Tough sledding. They lose a yard there on third.
No surprise they decided to throw on third down. A little bit of a surprise that they completed the pass and lost yardage on the play.
Here's Dustin Colquitt now as he's on to punt for Atlanta. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. 35 yards that time on the punt, and out will come the offense as they take over. New England trying to get a place on offense, and they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Yep, run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
A handoff to Harris to begin the drive. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
Well, it's hard to have vision as a runner and find a hole when there's nothing but defenders in your way. They stacked that one up really well. But give him credit. Instead of trying to bounce it out and turn it into a big play, which might have turned into a big loss, kind of just took his medicine there and took the 1 yard.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
Well, to me, there is no question about the intent there, and I think he was a little fortunate that the penalty flag didn't come out for grounding. But he'll get away with it and get another shot on third down.
New England on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is third and nine. Looking to throw. Jones. Going up top. And unable to connect, incomplete. Now give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started, and that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty, and before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
And the punter Bailey on now as he sends this one away. It's a 42-yard punt. They keep him to just a yard on the return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. There again is the running back as he trots onto the field. They haven't been able to get him on track. They haven't been able to get this offense on track. No points so far.
Maybe it's time to start doing a few different things. Throwing the ball a little bit. Maybe featuring other people touching it for a while. And then you've got a chance to come back to him when things have changed a little bit. They have to make an adjustment.
Still time for him here as we sit in the second quarter. Ryan and the Falcons now come up first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. They run with Patterson. Now this will go for 5 up to the 33.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
Second and five now. Ryan. Open man is Kyle Pitts, his tight end. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Ryan on target to Pitts, first down Falcons.
Not too many teams will use a first-round pick on a tight end, so you know that when one does, he's got to be pretty darn special.
A small example of why they took him in the first round there. Nice little catch and run to get the good yardage.
On first down, Patterson. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and four.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four. Ryan. That's to the speedster Olamide Zaccheaus. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots 30. 17 yards is the pickup there for number 17.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Here's Patterson. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 49 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went 3 and out.
First chance in the red zone for the Falcons now. They come up first and 10 at the 16. And here's a handoff out of the gun. Kyle Van Noy back with the Pats in 2021 there on the tackle. Second quarter, 2 minutes remain. 3-0 our score. Second and 9, Ryan. That's into the hands of Pitts, the tight end. That catch good for 5. It's third down. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Here's the 7th play of this drive. This is 3rd and 4. Here's Ryan. And that is incomplete. Fine work by the Patriot D there, and it's 4th down.
I'm going to need some help with this one. How did he miss him? Wide open in the end zone. He's not hurried. He's not hit. And somehow, incomplete?
Yeah.
What happened?
During film study, that's one where he's just going to shake his head, not be able to believe it.
6 points go by the way.
And the holder's going to keep it. He's going to try to run for it. The fake field goal catches everyone by surprise. And the Falcons have taken the lead. So a fake field goal run in for the touchdown. That can be a huge momentum swing.
And that's got to drive a defensive coach and a special teams coach crazy. Someone else running it in on a fake field goal when you're supposed to be alert for it. Terrific play by the offense, not so much by the defense.
Now for the point after. And this is up and good to make it 7-3. That time a 9-play drive. And in the end, the finishing touch, an 11-yard run. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. On the return is J.J. Taylor. And he won't quite make it to the 25. Nelson Agholor and company getting set to go again on offense now. With them losing here in the second quarter and his limited productivity so far, you'd have to think they're going to try to look to him a little bit more, right?
I would guess you would start to see maybe some quick screens, some hitches, anything to get the ball in his hands quickly and let him try and do some damage after the catch. Or maybe just flip some formations and keep him isolated where it's more of a one-on-one route and get the ball to him.
I say just four verts, right?
Hey, why not? Four verts, one of the best routes in football. Hard to cover each guy all the way along the route.
So far, just one catch for him. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Partner, I think it's high time to get him some passes that he's comfortable with, some easy throws, some completions. He's not even hitting a 50% thus far.
Well, certainly that has played a big role into why they are trailing right now. From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. To throw again, Jones. He's going to look downfield for Henry. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
Well, when you've got a tight end who can run, you've got to give him a shot to unlock the defense. Want to see what they can get. Taking the big shot downfield. That one winds up incomplete.
On third down, here's Harris. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No chance. The Patriots send out their punter as he's on here to punt it away. Fair catch signaled for and taken just shy of the 30-yard line. So possession goes over here on the punt. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. A look at the running back, the man out of the backfield as he gears up to go again. He's been effective so far over the 40-yard mark here in the second quarter. Don't forget about those guys up front, though. They've been effective, too.
The leverage game has been in their favor. They've been the ones who've been able to bend their knees, drop their hips, and get a little bit lower than the guys on the other side of the football, and they've moved them out of the way for the runner.
Sometimes that's tough for those big fellas.
Not an easy thing for them to do.
On first and 10, it's Ryan. This one left side caught by Patterson. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts, as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. ...13 yards remaining on second down. From the shotgun, Ryan. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
Well, partner, they're not content to run this one out as we head towards the half, trying to hit a big chunk play right there and add to their score.
Yeah, this is a confident group. At the very least, they're thinking field goal.
Yeah, and I don't blame them one bit. I don't think you sit on the ball going into the half when you have a chance to put some more points on the board.
On third down, it's Patterson. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. Here's Dustin Colquitt now as he's on to punt for the fourth time tonight. Fair catch called for and taken right near the 30-yard line. It'll wind up just a 35-yard punt, no return.
Damian Harris of the Patriot offense ready to take over again.
He's had a good chunk of carries. Problem is for very little success. I don't want to put it all on his shoulders, but that's a big reason they're losing right now.
Have to be very careful that he doesn't start pointing fingers. Offensive line obviously trying. The defense has done a nice job against him today. When it's all said and done, It's all about the guy in the mirror. He has to get it done better going forward.
See if he can look and do some soul searching now. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Throwing to start the drive. Jones. Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack.
These sacks now, they're starting to pile up, Charles. And that front seven defensively, they've had their way with this offensive line.
And I think at this stage, we have to start thinking about different play calls. We've got to start helping this quarterback out because the entire game he's been under siege. I don't care what the down and distance, they've got to get the ball in his hands a lot quicker.
Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. The final shot before break. Jones.
And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground.
So we are at halftime here in Atlanta with the Falcons out in front. As we'll send you down to Orlando, and we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome, everyone, to this abridged version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. First things first, though, let's get a check on the next-gen stats from that first half for New England. And I can imagine the halftime discussions are about how can we improve the running game. They have not had success so far, and it's reflected on the scoreboard. Meanwhile, for the Falcons, they had a little bit more success on the ground than their opponents did, and that should set them up well for the second half to come.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number three. The Patriots trailing here, but they will have the football first as the third quarter is underway. Taylor now to return it. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. Here comes Mac Jones and the rest of the Patriot offense.
And I guess the question, Charles, is what's the formula for keeping him better protected? Because as we see, the protection, it's struggle.
And normally what you get is renewed determination. When the big guy gets hit, that usually sparks people. Hey, we can't let this happen anymore. They take it personally. He's not supposed to be on the ground, but that hasn't been the case so far in this game. So maybe they've got to figure out how do they get rid of the ball faster to help out the offensive line so he doesn't get hit as much.
And we'll see if they can keep him off the ground now going forward. The Pats at the line ready to go. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
Well, in every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse than a four-yard run on first down.
6 yards left on second down. Back to throw. Jones. Complete. Hunter Henry with a grab. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
And he is not going to get the first down as he'll spot this at about the 28. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a fourth down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
The Patriots send out their punter as he'll come on to kick this one away. They call it 38 yards on the punt, no return. Here comes the Falcons offense. It's their first possession of the second half now. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Ryan will bring the Falcons up now, first and 10, right at the 30. To throw is Ryan. And he'll complete this one to Patterson. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon, and it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
On first down, Ryan. And this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well and that one's incomplete.
Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10. Here's Ryan to throw. Looking deep downfield. He's got a man, complete. Touchdown, Falcons. Kyle Pitts, 58 yards. And the Falcons push further out in front. So many times you think of these tight ends catching the ball already in the end zone, but today's tight end, they can run after the catch too to score.
They are big, they're strong, but they're extremely athletic, and they can surprise the heck out of you when they get the ball in their hands and they're running away from the defense.
Koo for the extra point. And this one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. The drive there only spanning three plays. And the Falcons score to cap it off. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. On the return, it's Taylor. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20.
Don't give him nothing. Don't give him nothing.
The Patriots ready to try again on offense. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline and puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. And the drive starts with a carry by Stevenson. A strong running. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Nice satisfying run on first down for the offense, picking up five, which means defensively, the thought process is entirely different. You don't want to panic, but at the same time, you're saying to each other, we've got to tighten this down. We can't give up gains like that.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Operating from the gun. Jones, and that throw behind his man, he missed him, incomplete. Kendrick Bourne, the intended receiver, and it'll bring up third down.
That was well defended. They clamped down on every available receiver. Just got to give the win to the defense on that snap.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Looking to throw, Jones. That's caught left side, Myers with it. And he will have a Patriots first down. He needed five. He got it barely, as it will officially go down as a gain of 5 yards.
And there's absolutely zero pressure on the quarterback on that play. Third down, and he has all the time in the world to eventually find an open receiver for a first down pickup.
Jones now on first down. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
So now they'll come up on second and 10, once again from the 28. They'll try the right side with Harris. And not much, maybe a yard up to the 29. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
These guys have punted four times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. But he'll let this go deep for Bourne. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
The Patriots send out their punter as he'll come on for his fifth kick of the night. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. 37 yards on the punt with no return. Now after the punt on that play, we've got a man down on the field. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there. Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. Once more, they turn to Patterson. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 75 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here, because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football. Sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Throwing now, Ryan on first down. He's going to have to hook up to Gage. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Second and seven. Now it's Ryan. Over the middle, Sharp's got it complete. And he's going to get seven out of this before being taken down at the 27. An extra corner comes on now for the Patriots D on third down. And to give this time to the tailback. And finally down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Brandon, what were they thinking on defense there? They looked like they were playing for the pass. That was third and short. Yeah, it was an easy pickup because they handed it to him. That was way too easy.
Just looked like absolute confusion defensively. Not sure why they were in that set.
Yeah, I'd say you ought to have a few men in the box there.
Now it's Ryan. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
But listen, when you've got the lead, there's absolutely no sense trying to fit a ball in where you shouldn't. You can see the coaching in his head taking place on that play because he saw he had a receiver in the area and just put it well over his head out of harm's way.
They'll try again here from the 7 on second and goal. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll work his way closer to the goal line as he's got 5 down to the 3.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive. Because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense getting a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard.
3 tight ends up front here, 3rd and goal. Here's Davis. And he will take it in for a Falcon touchdown. Mike Davis, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Falcons will add on to their lead.
So the toss play effective, even down here near the goal line.
Yeah, and you're hoping the defense commits too many men to stop the run in the middle of the field and that your blockers can gain a little bit of an advantage. And when they do, foot race to the pylon. And this time, he had the speed to win that race.
Two now for the point after. And it's 21-3. A good drive that time as they go 9 plays in all. And it ends with a 3-yard scoring run. The kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
Taylor now to return it. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26. New England's offense set to go. And here we are almost through 3 quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
Now Jones on 1st and 10, out right to Bourne.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
They'll come up now on 2nd and 1 yard. From the gun, it's Stevenson. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, 1st down.
We got this.
And that is going to do it. For this 3rd quarter of action, this is the National Football League on EA Sports. Back now in Atlanta. It's Patriot football, but they trail here as we begin the fourth quarter. Throwing Jones. Checking this down to Stevenson. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
Was that a receiver? Yeah, actually it was. It was a running back who was a receiver on the play. Ikey's been spending time in the receiver drills getting his feet down.
Well, those guys out of the backfield, they got to be good, agile with their feet. He showed the agility there with a toe tap.
No doubt about it. It's like he'd run to ballet school. Got the toes down and stayed in bounds.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. He started out having some troubles back in the first half connecting with his receivers. Really hasn't gotten a whole lot better.
Yeah, he's at less than 50%, and you and I both know that just won't do. So I would think about spreading things out, putting it on the receivers, make them win those one-on-one battles on the perimeter and find their way open.
But this pass is going to wind up incomplete. At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense, they're just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
Got to try it here. He's back to throw. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And got his man complete. And he takes this thing way down into Atlanta territory. But no reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth.
At this stage, there's nothing left to do but to keep firing. And if you're a play caller, you may go off your sheet and use some things maybe you hadn't planned to in this game. Maybe that was one of them there that worked.
So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Now Jones. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. Another pass attempt, another incompletion. You figure defensively, you're in the fourth quarter here, you've held the team under 100 yards passing. You've done your job.
Especially in today's NFL, which is truly a pass-first league.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. They hand this off to Harris. And here he'll get it down to the 7. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
New England on third down. They're hitting at just 30%, 3 for 10. This will be 3rd and 6. Back to throw. Jones. Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
Fultz's kick is good, and that'll get the deficit down to 15. Well, with that field goal, you can argue they needed to get back within 2 scores, and they did indeed do that, but still a pretty uphill battle.
Still going to take 2 fourth-quarter touchdowns to get back into it, and as you and I know, that's a tall order against any NFL defense. They're going to need their own defense to make some plays as well to give them an opportunity.
Now, after the field goal, Bailey will kick it away. Now it's Patterson. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20.
Atlanta regains possession of the football. Now, there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
Ryan and the Falcons now come up first and 10 at their own 19-yard line. Ryan. Throw left side, complete to Shard. And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. An ideal spot here to get a first down and try to run some more clock. And this is second and less than a yard. They go play action with Ryan. Got this complete to the tight end Pitts. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. That'll put him at 96 yards receiving now for the game, and he's got a first down as well.
Well, that should be a reminder defensively, and I think it's a reminder to myself because you just can't sell out to stop the run. There's still enough time that this offense can move the football through the air, even on first and second downs, and they obviously picked the right spot to throw the ball there.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll take it across the 50 and into New England territory. 109 yards on the ground for him now as he has gotten better, really, as the night's gone on. If you can keep getting gains like that, Charles, with the lead here in the fourth quarter, I mean, keep running it, right?
No doubt about it. But what the offense coordinator has to do is understand they're going to continue to stack the line of scrimmage. What runs do you have in your arsenal that'll work against a stacked box and continue to move the ball?
And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a third and four. Out of the gun, it's Ryan. And intercepted, maybe the turning point they need. Picked off at the 40, and he's just across midfield and down at the 49-yard line. Two-score game here in the fourth, and that pick, it kind of keeps the door ajar, doesn't it?
It does, and you wonder about their strategy because with a two-score lead, you would think maybe you're just sitting on and trying to drain some clock. It's almost like they felt like, hey, we've got a good cushion. We can keep pressing it. It ended up costing them.
Now the Patriots gearing up to go now. The interception was a great starting point, but now they need points pretty quickly, down two scores. Here's Jones, throwing on first down. Open man is born. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. You got the big lead defensively, willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
5 yards remain on second down. From the gun, Jones. And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Grady Jarrett, his second sack of the night.
Just not much a quarterback can do there, CD. The pressure was in his face almost instantaneously, led to a very quick sack.
And it appears that this was just a letdown from the offensive line, but they do have a tough job because if you're a big tackle out there on the perimeter, sometimes you don't have the agility to keep up with the defensive end who's looking to wreak havoc in the backfield. And he got there and put his man on the ground.
He'll dump this down to Stevenson. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. He did his best to just get four out of that, but not enough. And now fourth down. Come on,
As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. To the sideline, and he's got it. They say the feet are down. Yes, the line judge says they're in. That'll be a first down. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Operating from the gun, Jones. That ball's caught. Aguilar, right side. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. 7 yards to pick up there.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he can get a good head of steam going.
On second down now, it's Harris. And down inside the 15 he goes. 15 yards there on the play as they try to chip away at this 15-point deficit. Now, yes, a two-possession game, but a good chunk of time on the clock, so they have the ability still there to run it on second and short, but maybe they need to pick it up a bit.
You're right. They did pick up the first down there, but they, as you mentioned, they have to pick up the pace now because it's a two-possession game. They've got to get there twice to make sure they have a chance to win.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. Well, they'll run it here on the jet sweep. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. 10 more there and another first down.
I think the reason this play is so successful is not just the blocking at the point of attack, but how about the speed at which he takes the handoff? He's in motion already, so he's not coming from a flat start like a running back often is. He's at a full run by the time he gets the football.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Harris, nothing doing there. They're going to wind up holding him at the 2. No gain there, and it's going to set up second and goal. So stuffed from the 2, now what?
You know me pretty well. What do you think I want here?
Play action?
Definitely. Let him get outside and create, and if he has to run it, he has a little bit more space.
Second down and goal. Jones. There's Henry. Touchdown, Patriots. 2 yards on the touchdown there. And the Patriots get a score closer.
So this now a 9-point difference. You figure the book here says kick the extra point, make it a 1-score game.
Now, you and I have seen coaches get overly aggressive in this spot, but I agree with you. Kick it here and get back within a score.
And now in a 9-point game, they'll still just need to go for 1 here. As this gets them back within a touchdown and a 2-point conversion. So that drive consumes 9 plays all told, and it's finished off by a Pats touchdown. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. Cordero Patterson to return it, bringing it out of the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. Atlanta prepped and readied for its next possession. I'm curious to see, Charles, about the play calling on this drive. Last time out, the interception that led to a touchdown. Here we are. I mean, very close. 1-score game.
Yeah, and if I'm a defender, I'm actually chirping to you on the other side of the ball, saying, hey, we picked off the last one. What you going to do about it now? So when you do throw the football, high percentage, but throw it with confidence. If there's any hesitancy at all, it could end up in enemy's hands again.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Complete to Zacchaeus. A gain of six there on first.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. They've got a second down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. And tackled down after a gain of three, leaves them with 1 yard to go on third down. So fresh out of the two-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. Now this is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here. They'll keep it on the ground. Patterson, and he's going to run into a brick wall right in the middle of the field, and I don't think he got there. And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause in the action. A timeout here defensively. Here's Dustin Colquitt now, as he's on to punt for Atlanta. It'll be a 39-yard punt, no return.
Let's go.
So now Jones and the Patriots, down 21-13, a minute 46 to go. How will this thing pan out? We'll watch as they come up on first down. Jones. Connecting with Aguilar. They'll contain him to just four. Second down. Gosh, given the time and the short game, would he have been better off just dropping that?
Yeah, when you look at the clock, you think so. But it's hard to get a receiver to drop a football. They're trained to catch everything.
Now the Patriots moving quickly, hustling up to the line. Jones. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Grady Jarrett in there to drop him as that clock continues to run. And you hate to say it with a rookie quarterback. He's done some good things, but overall, looked a little bit overwhelmed back there, hasn't he?
He certainly has. But in his defense, he hasn't had a lot of time to throw the football. You like the way I said that? In his defense.
In his defense. I got it.
You see what I did there?
He needs better protection, that's for sure. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. It's a pickup of 13, but they're still a bit short, and it'll be fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. They're going for it. This is Harris. Oh, and they had him stopped short of the first, but a penalty marker down. And that looked like a clear face mask to me.
Hey, baby, this ain't good enough for us.
Well, when you're leading in the fourth quarter, that's not the penalty you want.
Not at all. And now your discipline comes into question. Having poise this stage of the game, you can't have those kind of plays.
So the penalty yards marched off on the face mask. Here's first and 10. Here's Jones. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete.
Whew, that's certainly not the worst thing. It stops the clock and lets your offense catch its breath and lets us exhale a little bit. Now I expect them to call a couple plays in the huddle so they're ready if a tackle happens inbounds.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. To throw is Jones. And this throw incomplete. Well, the defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down. Couple extra defensive backs out there in the dime, and because of that, really not many places to throw the football, if any.
And typically, what would you want to do against that dime?
Run the football.
You want to run the ball, but you can't do it in this situation. Not nearly enough time on the clock. You have to really navigate against a tough defense presented against you.
And a pass to Henry is intercepted. Picked off by Daron Harmon. And the Falcons have just about sewn up this football game. Third and long that time. He was trying to make something happen, but a little too risky.
Well, the field tilted on him. And what I mean by that is what you said. Third and long. Got to push it downfield to try and pick up the first down. Defensive backs live for this situation. And they took advantage of the young man right there.
Here are the Falcons as their offense heads back onto the field. And this one all over but the shouting, you might say. Now, there's one timeout remaining defensively, but probably no real need to use it here.
Yeah, the only time they would use it, strictly for pride.
The Falcons in victory formation as they take a knee. The Patriots will take their third and final timeout as they get it with 16 seconds remaining on the clock. Ryan heads down to a knee, and that should wrap this one up. Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.